And welcome back to This Week. Time now to get the views of our media and political experts, Metro Councilman-at-Large Jerry Maynard and syndicated talk show host Steve Gill. Gentlemen, welcome. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays.
In the wake, obviously, of the Sandy Hook Elementary School shooting, horrible, horrible event, gun sales are up. There are more calls for gun control legislation at least be discussed. Is this the tipping point where something is going to happen?
Something has to happen. And I'm a believer in the Second Amendment. I believe that you have the right to own a gun. The question becomes what type of gun. I believe that a weapon of war should not be available to the general public. I believe that you have to have background checks. If you have to register to be an investment banker, you should have to register to be a gun owner, and you should have a background check the last 5 days to give you a red flag whether you have any mental health issues, criminal background, all of those different things that would give us an indication that you may not should have a weapon. I believe you have to have a background check, and we have to do a ban on assault weapons, those weapons that are weapons of war.
Well, I think the problem with that is that our founding fathers intended that we be armed with the kinds of weapons that we can protect ourselves against a government, which is exactly what the assault weapons, not the automatic weapons, mm-hmm. those are already restricted severely. The kind of weapon that was used in this case is the kind of weapon that if you don't have, then you're completely at the risk of what your government decides to do to you. And that's why this country was set forth with the protections for the citizens, not to go hunting, but to be able to protect ourselves from a government that would be overreaching. And you look all over the world at countries where people's rights have been taken away. First, they've disarmed them. Then they've come for them, not just their guns. I think the other thing is to keep in mind that while a lot of the restrictions that Jerry's talking about are good ones, we do have a background check, an instant check that keeps the mentally ill, those who have a background record from getting the weapons. In fact, the shooter at Newton, Connecticut, was denied purchasing a weapon because of those restrictions in place. But if somebody's going to kill their mother and steal the weapons, none of the things we're hearing talked about right now would have prevented this shooting, other than maybe having somebody in that school who could shoot back.
That's why you cannot limit it to just the Newton. People are being killed every day. Children are dying in New York, Chicago, all over the country. And what is happening is 40% of all gun sales, there is no background check, either because of loopholes or gun shows. And so Steve is right. Some states do have very restrictive background checks and regulations. But then there are other areas like in Virginia and other states where you can go to a gun show or you can go to Dick's Sporting Goods and you can buy an automatic weapon of war and for the public to buy it. We've got to have a national law that states that you have to have a background check for every sale, and some weapons need to be banned.
Everybody. Well, you cannot buy an automatic weapon at a gun show in Virginia. That's just not the case. Those are restrictions nationally. You can't buy a fully automatic weapon. That's just not the case. Second, at these gun shows, if you're a dealer, a gun dealer selling at the gun shows, the same restrictions apply as if you're selling out of your store. What the difference is whether I, as a private citizen, can sell Jerry a gun as a private citizen, and forcing people to go through that kind of restrictive prohibition is what now people are talking about to try and prevent me as a private citizen from selling Jerry a gun, and I think that's wrong. Where you're seeing the guns used most heinously to murder literally dozens of people per month is in places like Chicago that have the most restrictive gun laws in place. If the gun laws aren't protecting us there, we need to look at protecting people by letting honest, decent citizens protect themselves.
Everybody wants their kids safe. Here in Tennessee, there's a proposal to arm teachers. The NRA today came out with a proposal to have armed officers in schools. Are those the approaches? The armed officer sounds like a more reasonable approach that people may be on board with, but again, who's going to pay for all this, and do we want armed teachers?
The opportunity to have resource police officers in our schools is a good idea. The problem is the NRA was blaming everybody, media, video games, and everyone else, and basically stating that NRA is a victim. I mean, the tone of his press conference was just horrible because it was insensitive to the victims of Newton, and it was insensitive to the real issues facing us. This is a complex issue, and he did not handle it in that way. I will say this, is that if you're going to have resource police officers, then give us the budget and the money to pay for it. We've been cutting our education. We've been cutting our budget for police officers. You can't have it both ways.
Well, I think, again, you want to look at the actual facts of the situation. If you have an armed police officer in these schools, that's better than having nothing. But the problem is, if I'm going in as a nut judge, deranged guy, and the only guy in that school who has a gun is the police officer, I'm shooting him first. Mm-hmm. And then again, I've got free rein on the rest of the school. When we put people on airplanes with guns to protect us on airplanes, they're not wearing uniforms. We don't know who they are. We don't know which planes they are on. We're not talking about arming teachers, but giving teachers who are able to possess a handgun already because of a carry permit, making sure that they meet the restrictions in the school system, have some training, and then nobody knows who has the guns in the school. Then you've got a better system, I think, than arming police officers.
We have to leave it there. Steve Gill, Jerry Maynard, appreciate your time and your insight. Stay with us. This Week continues in a moment.